energy tech ShineHub announced Australia's first choose-your-own retailer virtual power plant. What does that mean for homes generating solar power? ShineHub co-founder Alex Giorgio joins us via Skype to explain. Hi, Alex. Welcome to the show.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Great to have you on. Now, Alex, trials of virtual power plants have been going on for a few years now. So I'm really interested, have we finally got to a point where they're viable? And for those unfamiliar with the concept, can you explain how a VPP works?
Yeah, I'll start there if you don't mind. How a VPP works is it takes a collection of residential batteries, so homeowners that have a solar battery system in their house, and it links them together into a unified group. And that group can provide on-demand renewable power from their batteries to the grid, to the community. And so at its core, a virtual power plant is linking together a series of hundreds or thousands of batteries and allowing that power to be used in concert when needed by the grid. Okay. Now, in return for that, homeowners get a payment for allowing their battery power to support the grid. And so it does two main things. It progresses renewables on the grid, and also it allows homeowners to get extra savings from their battery.
And is this available anywhere in the country, or is it limited to certain states or locations?
There's been a number of virtual power plants over the last year that have popped up, and those have all been with a retail partner. The unique thing about the community virtual power plant that we're leasing now is that it's not with a particular energy retailer. And so that's a very unique thing, and it's coming from customer feedback. They want the flexibility to change retail plans and so forth, but they still also want to participate in these virtual power plants. And so this product is first of its kind. It's available right now in South Australia, Victoria, and New South Wales, statewide across those three states.
So take us through how it works. I understand on the open energy market that sort of suppliers are buying their energy from various power plants and they pay a price and they pay premiums and all sorts of things going on. Is it a similar concept when you go down to this little local community version?
Yes and no. So most of the virtual power plants that have been in the market today are partnered with retailers, like I said. And the way they're used is to primarily buy and sell energy on those energy markets, right? The difference with what we're doing now is we're actually contracting with the grid providers. So the people that are the companies that are responsible for keeping the grid stable, the poles and wires companies. Mm-hmm. And so those companies are separate to electricity providers. They're not buying and selling electricity. All they're doing is making sure the grid stays on, there's no blackouts and that sort of a thing. So they are willing to pay a premium price over and above the price of normal grid power. For the use of the customer's battery. And that's also a very unique thing, is that customers get 45 cents a kilowatt hour, typically double the price of grid electricity in most jurisdictions, when they allow their battery to be sent back for the use of the grid.
And that's even like four times the supply you normally get for tipping your power into the grid anyway.
Exactly. Exactly. And just to be clear, that 45 cents is only when the VPP is activated. So your normal early afternoon solar is still going back into the grid if your battery is full and you're getting that smaller credit. But those credits have continued to decline. So what the virtual power plant does is it as those are declining, it actually replaces it with a much more beneficial one for the wider community and the state and the country as a whole.
So you've recently announced the VPP. Can you just give us a bit of background on ShineHub? How long have you been operating, and was this always the end goal for the company?
Well, it's been quite a long story. And I was just chatting to some university graduates the other day about this story. And I think a lot of times people think that this entrepreneur idea or the startup story is you have a light bulb moment and you have the vision in your head and you just build exactly that. And it definitely has taken some twists and turns. We never thought we were going to be a virtual power plant operator. We always thought of ourselves as a solar marketplace to give people access to the best products, payment options, and virtual power plant solutions. When we tried to sell virtual power plants in the past, they typically have had hardware component, which just meant an upfront cost. And so we didn't think that was a very viable model. And we decided to build one ourselves that was all online, no cost to join, just get benefits as we use your battery and no cancellation penalties or anything like that. So Because we couldn't find the product that we wanted and we thought would be good for people, we decided to build it ourselves.
I think in the 15 years ShineHub's been around, of course, a lot of this technology didn't even exist. So these possibilities have opened up along the way. Where do you see everything going next? I'm really interested, Alex, in how you see the energy market playing out with renewables and concepts like a virtual power plant.
Yeah, and it's why we focused on batteries and virtual power plants as a whole, because it's the key to unlocking a much more stable, cost-effective energy transition for Australia. If you look right now nationwide, about 80% of power is coming from coal, right? And that's providing a nice, stable, consistent baseload power. But no one's building new coal power plants because it's not financial, and there's also a lot of environmental pressure, right? The not financial part is very, very important because banks won't fund it. And so as those power plants come offline in the next 10 to 15 years, what's going to replace that, right? Now, I'm a big fan of wind and solar, but wind and solar can only help when the sun is shining and the wind is blowing, right? For example, right now, there's days in the last summer where there was so much solar power on the network that the network was totally covered with just renewable energy, right? And so what we don't necessarily need just more renewables producing when the sun is shining and the wind is blowing. What we need is to be able to transfer that power into the times when there's not wind and solar. And if there's not coal in the future, then what's going to satisfy that? So option one is just gas, just building a bunch of big gas power plants, which would do it. But environmentally, from a cost perspective, long term, those costs really start to add up. So having virtual power plants, both at a community level and at a residential level, is forecast to be up to 30% of Australia's total energy mix in 10, 15 years, which is hugely significant. One third of all power that Australia as a nation uses on a daily basis could be coming from virtual power plants.
Alex Giorgio, it sounds fascinating and a really interesting future ahead of us. Great to have you on today talking about ShineHub and all the best for the future and the virtual power plant. Cheers.
Appreciate it.